What's up, everyone? Michael Ruddle, immigration attorney, here with another video for you on how immigration affects everyone. And in this video, I'm going to answer the question on how to verify the source of your investment funds for an E2 visa in the United States. Today's question actually came from one of our viewers who's looking to apply for an E2 visa and asked what they need to show as proof that their investment funds are legitimate. So I'm going to give you a quick summary and then we'll get into it in more detail. You've heard the phrase follow the money. Well, if you are applying for an E2 visa by investing in a US business, then that is exactly what you have to do. The US government wants to make sure that any money you are investing in a US business comes from legitimate legal sources. Proving that your money is legitimate and not from, say, a drug trafficking empire means providing complete money trail of the funds invested, including origination, accumulation, and the path of those funds. First, let's talk about origination. This means what was the source of the money? How did it get into your hands? Was it the sale of a property, an inheritance? Did you win the lottery? Did you sell a business? Or did you just save money from your day job over time? All of those ways are fine because they are legal, but you must provide documentation to show this origination. Second, accumulation. This means explaining how the money went from your hands into a US bank account. Did you deposit it in a foreign account first and then make a wire transfer? Did you open a business bank account in the US and just deposit it there? Or did you bring a bunch of cash with you through the airport and declare it at customs? Again, these are all usually fine, but the government wants to make sure that the money you obtained legally is the same money you're using to invest in your new business. And so you will need to show this through sufficient documentation. Finally, the path. This means describing how these funds you're using are spent for a qualifying business expense to get the business operational. This can include invoices, bank statements, canceled checks, etc. Of course, other rules do apply, such as the investment amount, whether it's substantial, but for now, just know that whatever business you decide, you will need to help the government follow the money and verify that your investment funds were obtained and spent legally. If you have questions about an E2 case, please feel free to reach out to us to speak to an immigration attorney. We've helped E2 clients with investments as little as $20,000 up to $10 million in a wide range of businesses. So visit our website today to schedule an appointment with an experienced E2 attorney. Thank you for watching. Until next time, I'm attorney Michael Ruddle. Keep climbing that mountain.